Today, let's learn about related rates. If you remember four things, you can easily solve related rates problems. First, condition. Find out what condition is given in the problem. Second, question. Identify what the problem is asking for. Third, relation. Try to relate the variables given in the condition and question. Lastly, differentiate the relation with respect to time. Now, let's apply this to solve a common related rates problem, circular ripple problem. When a droplet falls into calm water, it creates a ripple in the shape of concentric circle, and the ripple moves away from the center as shown in the left video. If you call the radius of these concentric circles as r, and if the radius r increases at a rate of 1 meter per second, can you find how fast the area enclosed by the circle is increasing after 2 seconds? Yes, we can easily find the answer by identifying and organizing the four key components we learned earlier. First, let's examine the condition given in the problem. The condition is simply dr over dt equals 1 meter per second. Second, we want to know how fast the area is increasing with respect to time. The question becomes dA over dt, and we need to find this value at t equals 2. Thirdly, let's find a relation that connects the given condition and the question. The variable in the condition is r, while the variable in the question is a. The way to connect these two variables is through the formula for the area of circle, which is a equals pi r squared. Now, for the last step, let's differentiate the relation we found with respect to time. Applying implicit differentiation, we get dA over dt equals d pi r squared over dt. So dA over dt equals 2 pi r times dr over dt. Here, dr over dt is given as 1 meter per second in the condition, but we still don't know the value of r. However, from the condition, we know that the radius increases by 1 meter per second. So at 2 seconds, the radius becomes 2 meter. Therefore, the value of r is 2. Plugging in r equals 2 meter and dr over dt equals 1 meter per second, and simplifying, we get the answer as 4 pi meter squared per second. By applying the steps we learned, condition, question, relation, and derivative of relation, we are able to solve the problem easily. Please remember this order and apply it to solve math problems in the future. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe and like, and I'll bring you more informative videos in the future. Thanks for watching, and I've been your math guardian, Alex.